A good afternoon to you. I'm your host, Thabang, Segaecho. You're watching Open Studio. This is Cape Town TV, channel 263. I'm so glad that you could join us today. For many of you at home who might not actually be aware, Open Studio is a flagship program right here at Cape Town TV. It is a platform that is open to the general public to come in and chat to us a little bit more about that which they do in and around the community of Cape Town. Anything from community initiatives to projects or programs which are to the betterment of the community, this is the place to be. Should you wish to be our guest right here on the show, won't you drop us an email at janaid@capetowntv.org. And on today's show, I've got an amazing guest. This is Monica Buitendag, right?
Yes.
Who's a Chilean CEO from an amazing organization that's doing phenomenal work in and around Cape Town by the name of Heartlands Baby Sanctuary. How are you, ma'am?
I'm fine, thank you. And thank you for the opportunity. It's always a privilege to talk about the little children of Heartlands.
Definitely. I'm so glad you could make it to the show and welcome.
Thank you.
Great stuff. So shall we get straight to it? When was the Heartlands Baby Sanctuary actually established?
Well, it's almost 6 years ago that Heartlands started. Although we have a long history in childcare, we used to be part of a big national organization, and they took the decision of changing their strategic vision, and then they closed down the facility. Department of Social Development requested me then to continue with the same service. And that's when we started in May 2015.
Yeah, so it's been a long time running.
Yes, well, that's a long time.
That's really awesome. And I understand that you are the CEO currently, right?
Yes, the CEO and the founder of Heartlands, but also I was part in establishing the previous organization also. So this year I'm celebrating my 25th year in childcare. So.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
That is so awesome. I guess it takes a different kind of breed to really do what you do. So that's just phenomenal. Yeah, and what does your role actually entail as a CEO?
Sure, you know, managing the organization, the strategic vision of the organization, and making sure that we achieve the goals that we've set out. That we follow our vision and our mission and our values, and also addressing the needs in the community and really ensuring that the children that we take in, that we give a quality care. But, you know, Heartlands is not just about the children, it's also about the people working at Heartlands. So ensuring also that the staff are trained, that they know exactly what they need to do. And besides the CEO role, I also do the HR and I assist with the finances as well. So it's quite a big involvement for me.
Absolutely. And yeah, it sounds like you've got a multifaceted role right there.
Yes,
so you have your hands really full.
Absolutely.
That's really awesome. And what would you say makes your organization unique or rather outstanding from the rest?
I think also, you know, our history. Definitely that we, with the previous organization, we were one of three pediatric hospices in South Africa.
Oh, wow.
So it's a very unique kind of service that we provide. You know, people, when they drive past, they think, oh, it's just a place where children are staying. But it's much more than that. When we take in little children, we focus on their individual needs and we make sure that, you know, they become a little human being again. So our focus are really on the medical care, on the psychosocial care, and then the developmental care as well. So it's a holistic care that we provide. So it's not just, you know, feeding the children and bathing them. It's really much more than that. It's really creating a home for them, a loving home, a loving environment where they can be healed again. And our mission is then also is that it's every child's birthright to belong. So we want to make sure that a child is reintegrated in the community into a loving family.
Exactly. I love the fact that you've mentioned that it's a holistic approach that you actually try and embark, you know, as far as possible.
Yeah.
I'm sure there are obviously a lot of stakeholders who play that role, right? From your, I don't know, like the health aspect, the psychological aspect, the physical, etc., etc. So it is quite involved.
Yeah, it is quite involved. As I say, it's not just a little home where children come in and they play, they stay there for 24 hours. But we also believe that it's important for children to grow up in a community, not in an institution. Mm-hmm. And that's ultimate our goal. And I have to make sure, you know, that we will take in children, but also place them back in the community.
Right, which brings me then to the next question. How are the little ones then admitted into your facilities? What is the process?
Yes, it's quite a long process involved. So when there's a child in need of care and protection in the community, then the external social worker will go out and she will do an investigation. If she feels that a child needs to be removed, she has to contact a HUP, a Department of Social Development, and they will then see where the child is, in which area the child is, and what organization is closest to that area, and that will address the child's specific needs. Then the application is sent to us, and if we do have place, then we will admit the child. So, and the child must be placed with a court order.
Right.
So the court order is minimum of 3 months. And then after that, it will be renewed, depends on the child's needs also. But we also emergency place of safety. So if the police finds a child, they can place the child also by us.
All right, just for the sake of clarity, the age group, you know, with regards to the children that you admit into the facility, what is that?
That's newborn, absolutely newborn. Sometimes we will get a little baby that's been born on 32 weeks only weighs 1.9 kilograms. So it's very tiny little babies, up to 6 years old. We can accommodate 25 children at one given time. But sometimes we will, you know, if a child is in need, we will take the child in, especially because we're emergency place of safety. So sometimes we will care for up to 27, 28 children at one time.
At one time, right. Yeah. And when you say you're an emergency care facility, I assume there's it's a temporary placement facility,
yes.
Right? And how does that work?
Also the same is that the child has to, when a child's been admitted by, say, the police has brought the child in, there must be a specific form completed, and then it will be handed over to the external social worker, and then the needs will be addressed. So again, a court order has to be issued for the child to be legally placed by us.
Wonderful.
And we will then work, because we have an internal social worker also, and she works with the external social worker, and we will be agreeing on the long-term placement of the child. So sometimes it is not possible for the child to go back home. Either then we place a child in foster care.
Ms. Monica, do you mind if I just come in for a second?
Yes.
Just need to go for a quick break. When we come back, we'll just pick up where we left off.
Okay.
Please don't go away. We'll be right back. You're watching Open Studio. Welcome back. I'm your host, Thabang Segaecho. This is Cape Town TV, channel 263. The conversation continues with the Heartlands Baby Sanctuary, which is an amazing organization doing wonderful things in and around Cape Town. I am with Ms. Monica Buitendag's colleague, who is Ms. Nikki. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having us. It's always awesome to be here.
Rather welcome back, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Wonderful stuff. Thank you so much that you could make it. I understand that you're handling the marketing, fundraising and events department of the organization.
Absolutely, yeah.
Just briefly, what does that actually involve? I mean, considering that you are having to represent over 25 children and the sanctuary and that, which
and
is
32
just
full-time staff.
And exactly. Yes. So, and then you are the link between the external, internal. How is that like for you?
I think firstly, it's we've got a beautiful team. So that's really divine, is that this team is connected and very supportive of each other. So while we might be wearing 10 hats, it's actually all good because we've got each other's back. So that's divine. In terms of the marketing, what we've needed to do now is take it to the next level. We've increased a lot of social media, which is heartlandsbaby.org on Facebook and obviously our website. So we're increasing that. We're doing a lot of interesting posts because of the reach. We understand that it is interesting. We've also done quite a lot of radio and print with newspapers and celebrities and that kind of stuff. So we're just finding different ways. And this is especially since COVID. Mm-hmm. Because COVID, suddenly the fundraising landscape just went bang. And it was very, very terrifying. You know, what's happened though since then, it's been wow, because we brought in creativity and everyone's been brainstorming as a team, and we brought in new campaigns. So, and that's all sort of COVID-friendly campaigns. Mm-hmm. From the events point of view, well, of course, 220 was just a nightmare because we had all these amazing events planned, oh, wow, and then we had to ditch all of them. Mm-hmm. So now we have planned more for this year. We've got an incredible literary festival. It's the first festival of children's literature in the country. We've got over 50 authors confirmed, and that's the 2nd to the 4th of July. So that is really exciting. And then we've got another possibility, it depends also on COVID, but the Good Heart of Street Art, and that's going to be all chalk and mural drawings on sidewalks and painting on buildings. So we're very excited about that as well.
So am I. I'm looking forward to it. I mean, July already, I have to save that date. So it's us coming in, the general community, to come in, partake in that.
And there's a couple of celebrities involved, so you might
just make sure. Must we wait? No, yeah, now you're going to give us some names.
You can also do some signings.
Oh, I'll be there. I'll definitely be there. That is so wonderful. It sounds really exciting. I like the fact that you've went out of your way to get innovative, you know, and get creative in reaching the masses, because everything went online, like you said, yeah, pretty much. So I can only imagine. And I know that you've got several other exciting campaigns, yeah, as well. Earlier on, I was speaking to your colleague about the Adopt a Cot, right?
Right.
Adopt a Cot campaign. Won't you just unpack that a little bit for us? Because I understand that you have R100 as well, R100
okay,
campaign.
Okay, we've got basically different campaigns.
Yes.
I'll start with Adopt a Cot.
Okay.
What that means is we've taken all the costs, which it works out about R15,800 per month per cost.
Per child.
So it's per baby or per child. Then if you look at government's contribution and our sustainability contribution, we're only meeting about 50% of our costs. Mm-hmm. So just in a nutshell, that means we've got to raise nearly R2.5 million in cash
every year.
So that's the kind of cash we need to raise. So where Dr. Cott comes in, we've recognised the shortfall, which is R7,143 a month. Mm-hmm. And we're then asking people if you can put a debit order in place. You do get a Section 18A certificate, which makes your full donation 100% tax deductible. But even if it's not 7,000, if it's 1,000 a month, if it's 500, you know, every little bit counts and it adds up significantly for us. The R100 campaign, this is now also because of COVID and the businesses, mm-hmm, you've been hit so hard. So we've had to look out to the community, and we're saying just R100 a month can buy 2 tins of milk formula, it can buy 10 nutritious meals. So when you put it into context like that, mm-hmm, and you look at your banking fees, which are over R100 a month,
true,
it's kind of a, you know, it makes, yeah, sense. And, yeah, then also, why are you paying the tax man? Why are you, instead of supporting a charity? Because
exactly,
that's all that's happening, is your money is actually going to a better place. It's not, mm-hmm, costing you anymore. So the R100 campaign, we've extended into our Seeds of Hope Garden, which is our 5th sustainability project. And that is then you buy a piece of land. So that's awesome, because that's all our organic vegetables. We got the children in the coffee shop. And there's other sides to it. So, and we've got piggy bank campaigns, and we've got a new 6th sustainability project, but I'm going to about that for now.
Well, there you have it, viewers. You just have to make sure that you have your eyes glued on your social media pages. Won't you just give those to us again, please? Just
sure. On Facebook, it's heartlandsbaby.org, and for Instagram, it's the same.
It's the same.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So, won't you take me through the mother's room, which is obviously an interesting. I've never heard of this one before, but we spoke about it earlier on. What does that actually entail, the mother's room, in terms of the parents?
Well, what happens is a lot of the children come in with, say, serious health issues,
yes,
or because maybe the mother just, it might be very young and doesn't know how to care for the child and needs to learn about the medications, feeding, playing, all of that. Mm-hmm. So interacting with other children as well. So they will sleep over,
okay,
and participate for either a night or two. Our future plans are, with a new wing, we'll have two mothers' rooms with a dedicated kitchen, bathroom, and their own sort of lounge area. So that'll, and then a training room. So that'll also grow significantly with time.
All
so because
right,
it's a really important part of the child's health and well-being.
Right. Is this only limited to their biological mother? To
no,
the child,
I think, you know, with foster care, they also need to, never mind bond with the child, but they need to seriously look know how to look after the child.
Yes, yes, 100%. So are there any other programs that you'd like to mention that you are currently working on that obviously, of course, the community can come in still, that are ongoing, you know, aside from the events?
Okay, so I think the best thing is to come for a tour.
Yes.
Because although we're not going directly through the sanctuary, we can take you outside, but then you can see, still look through the windows and see everything that there is to see. And you'd be completely amazed by what our facilities look like. The outside of the building is incredibly deceiving, but it's big inside. I mean, to look after these children and to give them the care that they need, please come for a tour. It really would be wonderful to have you.
Wonderful stuff. And then again, I want to ask you, donations, you know, how can we best support your organization for somebody that's watching right now?
You can donate in any way. You can bring goodies, homeware, clothing, etc., etc., that we can then sell in our shop if we're not using it for our children. You can have a cup of coffee and a slice of cake in the coffee shop, and you can enjoy some retail therapy in the Chic Boutique. Those are just very easy ways.
The Chic Boutique.
We've got the Chic Boutique.
Oh.
It's a stunning secondhand shop, pre-loved. Okay. Babies, adults, children, homeware, everything. You can even get washing machines and so on. So it really is a fantastic way. And then, of course, financially, as I mentioned, it's well over $2 million a year that we need financial support.
Mm-hmm.
So any which way you can, but a debit order is really, we would so appreciate that.
Wonderful stuff. Yeah. There you have it, viewers at home. There are many ways you can actually help support the facility. We can go shopping, you know, there's so many things we can do. It's really, really quite exciting stuff.
Yeah.
And you're doing this all for a good cause. Again, thank you so much for making the time for coming through today.
Thank you for having us.
Really appreciate
thank
it.
You.
So thank you, viewers, for watching. It's just been great to have you, but we're going to go to a break. When we come back, we'll continue the conversation. Don't go away. Come back. If you just tuned in, you're watching Open Studio Cape Town TV channel 263. Earlier on, I was speaking to Miss Nikki Boa, who is actually a colleague, again, as you can see, to Miss Monica Buitendag of the Heartlands Sanctuary, which is just an awesome organization that's doing amazing things for the little ones. So we're going to continue the conversation, right? Miss Monica, 5 years to 6 years from now, where do you see the organization?
Sure, yeah, I think definitely, you know, to increase the number of children that we can care for. Currently, as I say, we can care for 25 children. We would like to increase that also. And that means also extending our building, so we want to build on. But also, you know, this is the kind of service we can't do on our own. So we would like to increase the community involvement. So definitely extend our sustainability project. So Nikki has spoken about our sustainability. We are focusing on the food gardens also, and that's something I really want to grow in, getting community involvement, training also, especially the parents that are involved with our organization, that we extend the support when the child goes back into the community. So it's really to grow that section as well, definitely. And to address more needs in the community, absolutely.
Absolutely, yeah, because they absolutely need your services.
And also, you know, currently we also do training for the mothers.
Mm-hmm.
So when a child is placed back or when a child placed in foster care, we train the mother how to look after the child, because the child will have some medical needs that she needs to address, and she must know how to look after the child. So also to increase that, so more training to be done in the community and the parents of our children.
Yes, I love that, because now the child coming from your care, having been accustomed to the level of care that you give,
yes,
it still needs to be maintained outside of the facility. So you have a really holistic approach again, which then helps aid, you know, the family at large, because you capacitate
absolutely
the mother, then the child gets taken care of.
I
love that. In terms of funding, you know, how can the community get involved, or an organization that could be watching right now, corporates, etc., how can we best support your organization?
Yes, I think that's always a challenge, you know, but to be financial stable is is really, it's a journey also. Mm. You know, if I think 6 years ago, where we've been with no funding almost, and Department of Health or Department of Social Development giving 25% of our funding, it's a quite a challenge. So,
yeah,
so
imagine,
Nikki
yeah.
and her team is really, you know, a challenge. But there are different ways that community members in the community can get involved. Mm-hmm. They can share their time, of course, first their finances, but also support our sustainability project. Mm-hmm. Then we also have corporates involved mm-hmm. that will also give us financial donations on a regular basis. And then the 100 Rand campaign, you okay. know, a 100 Rand campaign mm-hmm. can definitely buy a lot of nappies and a lot of bottle feeds as mm-hmm. well. Mm-hmm. So there are various ways of the community to get involved.
I like that. And on that, how do we actually get a hold of you then for somebody that's watching saying that, you know what, I would really like to lend a helping hand. How would they actually do so?
Well, they can phone us. I can give the phone number. It's 021-852-3527. Or they can email Heartlands. So it would be info@heartlandsbaby.org. Mm-hmm. And they can send an email and they can get involved.
That would be great. Yes, so viewers at home, there you are. You've got the contact details, please. Do extend a helping hand, because the work that the organization is doing is absolutely phenomenal and actually needed more now than ever before. So really, your assistance would really go a long way. And Adopt a Court, I understand that it's a campaign you're currently running, which is, I think it's amazing, you know, to say the least. How does that, if I want to actually jump in, how do I get involved?
So how we worked it is the expenses. You know, it's a 24-hour service. It's very professional people working, trained professionals. So the cost is high. So we've broken it down and, you know, the cost is then divided amongst the different services that we provide the child. So if somebody wants to contribute towards the cost of a cot, they can just contact us as well, and they don't have to give us the whole amount, but they can just give 50% or 25% or any cents, a little bit helps.
So yeah. If I understand you correctly, you've broken down the expenses
yes.
per child, which is obviously yeah. hence the word adopt a cot.
Yes.
So a person is able to have an idea of what's really involved
yeah.
in raising the children. So you've mentioned a couple of campaigns and projects that you're running. What can we expect for the rest of the year? There could be somebody saying that, well, I can't get involved right now, maybe later in the year. What can we actually be on the lookout for?
Yes, you know, with the COVID-19, we
yes.
had to now re-look at the future, and we had to also close our sustainability, some of our sustainability projects for a while, and all our fundraising events we had to stop, and we re-looked at this, and it was very exciting for us because you know, it brings new opportunities of how we can raise funds. Mm-hmm. So we're looking at a literacy festival soon.
Oh.
That's going to start in July. And we have the Wine to Wales fundraising as well. That will soon happen later in the year. Mm-hmm. So, yes, there are different campaigns that we then trying to raise funds for.
I like that, because you are basically saying that with COVID-19 hitting everybody, we never saw that one coming.
Mm.
You've had to obviously adjust and adapt so you remain afloat. Has the government met you halfway in that? I'm going to ask that specifically.
You know, there are many children homes, and I think we all were in the same boat. So it was difficult for the department to assist us financially. So we had to jump out and be more creative
yes.
in trying to raise funds. So during that period, we started a fundraising project, Circle for Running. So we did a 5 kilometers run every day for 10 days. And that's the way that we've raised almost over 100,000 rand. So there
that's
were different
amazing.
Ways that we, you know, put fundraising events together.
Wonderful. So viewers at home, there you have it. Thank you so much, Ms. Monica Buitendag, for coming through today onto the show, for sharing that which you do. And I really applaud your organization for the phenomenal work that you're doing in and around Cape Town. And with that, you've given obviously your details. So viewers at home, please do make an effort to just check in or visit. Can they come by?
Yes, yeah, absolutely.
Great. Visit the facility again. Thank you so much for coming through. To our viewers at home, we've come unfortunately to the end of our show. Thank you so much for tuning in. Be sure to continue watching Open Studio every single day, Monday to Friday at 5 o'clock. And thank you so much for tuning in today. May God bless.